subscribe to our YouTube channel, and don't forget to click on the bell icon to never miss an update.
Hi guys, welcome to another episode of JazzTech. This is Prashant Jaiswal, and today we are going to unbox AORUS AC300W R2 PC case, and we are going to shift our system from Deepcool Ducasse to this case. So first of all, we go to unboxing, then we'll move on to time lapse showing us changing our PC cabinet. So let's get started. So guys, let's start our unboxing. So here you have our AORUS AC300W R2, and we don't need a cutter, so let's throw this cutter out. No, I will not throw it away. I'll keep it here. So let's take it out of the box.
Front side with the AORUS logo.
And we will talk about the specifications and the outer box feature after taking the cabinet outside. So let's take out the cabinet outside. Since we have taken the cabinet outside, it's now easier to... Sorry guys. It's easier to read the... Move around the box and read the specifications. First of all, on the front you can see... Oh, at the back side. We have the label diagram showing us the features of this cabinet. A, having USB lights, which is customizable. Then we have transparent Windows side panel, not tempered glass. Then we have vertical GPU support. Then we have HDMI USB Type C cable on the front. Then we have PCU shroud, and we have detachable dashboard.
This is the front side of the box,
showing the cabinet and HDMI logo and USB Type C support. Gigabyte. On the back we have the official specifications and the diagram. Now, throw this box away. So we have our cabinet. In the box we get the installation guide, which is standard and pretty nice. So if you are new, you can go through the accessories list to get a full view. And one good thing I found about this manual was, you can see they have mentioned the screws. Let's have a zoom in. You can see the screws which are required for your installation, as well as the diagram, so you don't get confused in the screws.
This is our cabinet.
Here you have the front AORUS logo. So let's start our overview of the AORUS AC300W R2 cabinet. First of all, we have going to see our IO panels. Here we have, starting from the right, we have our power switch, then hard drive LED, then HDMI, then USB type 3.0, USB type B. Sorry, type A 3.0, then USB type C, then headphone and microphone jacks, and the power switch. Sorry, for the cycle power LED light switch, from which you can cycle the LEDs of the AORUS logo. And here have the mesh as well, which is magnetic and easily removable for cleaning. so it can easily filter clear the dust out of it. And then the front side of the cabinet, you can see the AORUS logo. This looks has a brushed aluminium like finish, but is not fingerprint magnet and is made out of plastic. And as you can also have our front dust filter here, which is removed from the tab here. Just pull the tab and you can see our mesh panel. On the right side, we have our large window. It's acrylic and not tempered glass, but it looks nice. And we have a slow remove of the screws to have a view inside. The screws are not captive, so that's make it not a good thing. Let me show you the screws. Here are the screws, non-captive one. Now let's remove the panel gently, and we will remove the plastic sheet afterwards after installing the moving out these components. Keep it somewhere safe, and you can see our clean internals. The internals are very clean. Motherboard standards are pre-installed. Here are our black sleeve cables for our IO and as well as the fan. They have included Molex for the fan, which is I don't think it's good. And here we have front 140mm intake, 120mm intake fans and exhaust fans. Fan as well. You cannot see the fan. Let me rotate the case a little bit. You can see the front our front 120mm intake fan. Its front is almost choked, so better remove the front fan to up. And this AORUS logo is RGB lit as well. And you can see our second fan having the again Molex and 3-pin. Now let's move, and as well as you can see we have a vertical GPU support, but it's since we have both vertical and horizontal, the vertical GPU is close to the panel. So if you install a vertical GPU, obviously the thermals will be high. Now let's have a view of the back side of the cabinet. This is a one good solid panel. It's quite heavy indeed. I have used 3 cases till now, spec 3 Ducasse and this one, and the panel is quite good. Here in the back side, you can see our 3 SSD caddies. Here you can see our 3 SSD caddies, 1, 2, 3. Then you have the 2 hard drive, 2 3.5 inch hard drive caddies. There we have our tools, and here have the front fan along with the Molex. And I suppose the Molex that was present in the bunch of cables on the front side was for LEDs and not for the cable. And there have the cables coming out from the front, which is most probably for the LEDs that are built under the cabinet. Now one more point, since we have a bottom down PSU, we can take out the fan filter easily just by pulling the tab here, and you can set it like this. Well, GPU PSU length support is not that great. It supports a PSU up to length. It's quite short, but it's okay for the price.
Now we have a view of the. Just we have to say about the box contents that comes with the cabinet. In this, all the accessories are packed and are labeled. You can see here we have 3.5 millimeter hard drive screws. All of these are packed individually so that you do not get confused. Here we have 2.5 inch hard drive and SSD. It's also labeled. Then we have motherboard. Then we have power supply. Then you have the vertical GPU bracket. Some zip ties, lot of them. Then you have some extra screws, some extra motherboard screws, as well as motherboard tightening screw, which converts your Phillips to motherboard sort of converter, which is nice addition. This is the first time I've seen in any cabinet. Cooler Master provided this type of tool in their cases. And you have this long screws, which are for mounting your GPU vertical GPU mount. So now we will move on to the time lapse showing changing our cabinet. So let's move on.
Oblivion. Oh, I wanna feel the dark.
So guys, this was our unboxing video of Gigabyte AORUS AC300WR V2 cabinet, as well as shifting our main system from the cooled case to this cabinet. This cabinet does not require RGB header for your RGB control. It requires USB 2.0, so any motherboard can be used for controlling the RGB on this cabinet. And to control this RGB, you require AORUS engine software, which can be downloaded from Gigabyte's website, and we will be mentioning that link as well in the description down below. And till now, after changing our cabinet from Ducasse to this cabinet, the cabinet seems pretty nice. The airflow looks good. And comment down below if you want to see an in-depth proper review of this cabinet. After getting likes or your comments, we will obviously do that. And this was our video, so do like the video if you like it, dislike the video if you dislike it, subscribe to our channel for more contents, and thank you guys.